Hello, my name is Greg Kopp from ArcherPoint. Today I'm here to talk about what's new in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013. This will be the first of several brief videos focused on the great work that the Microsoft Dynamics NAV product development team has been putting into the latest release of the product. This video will focus specifically on the user productivity enhancements. If you enjoy this video, please join me on LinkedIn, Twitter, follow my blog, or join me on YouTube to get the latest updates as I continue to produce more videos focused on Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013. So let's get started. The first thing you notice when you open up the Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 Windows client is that they have moved away from the concept of the action pane, and they have completely adopted the Microsoft Office Suite ribbon concept. Here in the Role Center, where we used to have an action pane, now we have a complete ribbon where they've grouped actions and commands into tabs and then further organized those action and commands into groups. Much like the action pane, you can come in and you have full control over how you customize your ribbon. You can create new tabs, groups, you can rename, you can remove, and you can basically take anything in NAV and surface it here on the ribbon to make it easy for an end user to find what it is they're looking for and do their job more efficiently and effectively. You can also right-click up in the ribbon, and you can control how much screen real estate the ribbon takes up. You can expand and collapse it. Another user productivity enhancement that they've included in this latest release of the product is if you go to any department page, whether it be financial management, sales and marketing, purchase, warehouse, manufacturing, jobs, resource planning, or service. Now, when you go to the history section of that particular department, you'll see not only all posted documents, but all of the ledger entries associated with that particular department. In Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013, they've also redesigned the call to options, so that if I wanted to place a call directly out of the application from, let's say, customers, contacts, or vendors, all I would have to do is go wherever I found a phone number that I wanted to call, select the dial icon, and what that's going to do in this case is actually look for the default communication provider from the specific machine I'm calling from. So in this case, I have Skype set up as my default provider, so when I select dial, it will immediately pull up Skype and dial that customer for me. The great improvement they've made here with changing how call to options work is because it's based on the client-specific default provider, you could support any number of providers, really making it much more flexible in terms of how end users are able to call contacts, customers, vendors directly out of the application. Another very useful productivity enhancement that they have included in this latest release is that if you go to a page such as a sales order, where you have information organized into header information up top and related line information below, you'll notice that there's a new menu area in the lines where they surface all of the functions, commands, and actions that can be taken on the lines, as well as an all-important find and filter feature right here on the lines themselves. Also, if you are in a list page, much like you could in previous versions of NAV, you can once again click in the top left corner, highlight all the rows, you can copy the rows, and you can paste them to an external application, but more importantly, once again, you can paste them, those rows, to other tables that are of the same structure and type. One final thing I'd like to focus on for this video is the ongoing work that the Microsoft Dynamics NAV product development team continues to do around making it easier for end users to understand messages that they receive from the application and help them interpret what they need to do about those messages. So in this case, I'm going to open up a sales order, which I know is a release sales order and will not let me make changes to the order. So I'm going to intentionally try to select a different customer, which it shouldn't let me do, and sure enough, it gives me back some error messages explaining why I can't change the customer on an already released sales order. Well, you'll notice the message bar always stays up here at the top. It gives me all of the related messages related to why this particular action has failed. And when I click on the specific message, it highlights the particular field that that message relates to. So I hope you'll agree with me that what they've done here in terms of making sure that messages always surface in the application in a consistent place, when you click on the message, it takes you right to the field that's affected. It makes it much easier for end users to understand the message that they're receiving and what they need to do about them. So this concludes my first video in the series, What's New in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013. I hope you've enjoyed this video on user productivity enhancements for the upcoming release of NAV 2013. I'd love to have you join me on LinkedIn, Twitter. Please follow my blog or join me on YouTube. And I will look forward to having you join me on a future production of What's New in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013. Thank you.